You have seen how comb attracts small pieces of paper after we rubbed it with our hair. Balloons striking to walls, sparks from the doorknob, all reveal that electric charges are everywhere. In fact, every object contains electric charge. Electric charge is a fundamental property of these particles, which are part of all the objects. However, for most of these objects, this charge is hidden, as object contains an equal amount of charge, that is positive charge and negative charge. With the balance of these positive and negative charges, the object is said to be electrically neutral. There is no net charge. When we say that object is charged, we really mean to say that there is an imbalance of charges. This imbalance is much smaller than the total amount of positive and negative charge in that object. Charged objects interact by exerting a force on one another. Similarly, charged objects repel while oppositely charged objects attract each other. The term electrostatic really means that relative to each other, charges are either stationary or moving very slowly. We also looked at atmospheric electric charge and how it results in lightning. We discussed about electrostatics, that is physics of stationary charge in short. Now let us discuss about physics of electric current, that is charges in motion. See, this is a copper wire. As you know, it is full of free electrons. What will happen if we join open ends together? Will electrons start flowing through the wire in circles? Not really. They will still move around randomly because there is no electric force which acts on them. If I take this battery and attach it to the open ends of the same wire, will the electrons flow through the circle? Yes. With the addition of battery, there is an electric field inside the loop, exerting forces on the conduction electrons to move and thus establishing current. Please note that if you do it for a long time, the battery might get discharged soon. SI unit of current is coulomb per second or ampere, denoted by letter capital A. We can say that current is really the rate at which charges pass through a point. Current is a scalar, as both charge and time are scalar quantities. Conventionally, the direction of current is from positive battery terminal to the negative battery terminal. Mechanically, a pump creates pressure difference in order to make water flow from a high pressure point to the low pressure point. A battery similarly creates an electrical potential difference to make the electrical charges flow from the positive, that is high potential point, to the negative, that means low potential point. Potential difference is the difference in energy value between two points. Let's take this bucket which is full of water. There is a potential difference of pressure between the top of the bucket and the bottom of the bucket. If I lift the bucket on this table, there is potential difference in the energy between height of the bucket and the ground. In electricity, there is a potential difference in voltage between two points. Voltage is equal to the energy per unit charge. The potential difference is measured in volts. For a battery, potential difference exists between two terminals. Summary. We discussed about electric current and electric potential difference. We'll learn more about electric circuit and electric cell in our next session.